Shalom to the elect of the nation of Israel, the elect of Yahweh Shai. All praises and glories due to Yahweh Barshem Yahweh Shai, Barshem Rakar Kodash, for giving us this knowledge, this truth, this understanding, especially in these times. So this video, and I hope it will be edifying to you brothers out there, as well as a few sisters that watch these videos. This video will be about principalities, which I'm gonna share with you the definition of a principality. It'll be about spirits, negative spirits, and how which we also call demons, which the word demon just means intelligence. When you look up the word, the etymology of the word, because we had Great Millstone, we practice something called etymology. When you look up the word etymology, the first part of the word etym is Greek for truth, and ology means study. So when you put it together, the word etymology means study of truth in words. How to correctly define a word, you have to go back to the root word. And usually the root words, they go back to the Hebrew, the Greek, or the Latin, because those were the three predominant languages back then: the Hebrew, the Greek, and the Latin. So for you to correctly define a word, you have to go back to the etymology of the word. So we here at Great Millstone, we practice etymology heavy, okay, in our doctrine, in the ministry. I have a saying, our stock and trade is in words. Okay, words is a great part of our profession. We're dealing with words. When you read the scriptures, you got to know the meaning, the true meaning of a word. And you can't be lazy. You got to look it up. Okay, like case in point, John 3:16, right? Now, the majority of these wacky-tacky Christians, they're blinded to the fact that the word world there in John 3:16, in the Greek, the word there is cosmos, which means a certain kind of world, a separate society. And what world is it talking about? It's talking about the world of Israel, beginning with the elect, for God so loved the world. But because the wacky-tacky Christian, majority of them are lazy, and they don't do research, they think when you read John 3:16, it's talking about the whole world, as in everybody in the world. God loves everybody in the world, and that's simply not true. The one nation that the Heavenly Father loves is the nation of Israel, the Israelites. Period, the world of the Israelites. The Israelites is a world in itself. Read Isaiah 45:17. World without end. It's talking about the world of Israel. Okay, so that's a strong point which proves the importance of looking up the meaning of words, the importance of etymology. All right, that's a strong point which proves it. Okay, so the word principality, when you go into it, it means first rule. All right, among the etymology of the word principality, it means first rule. And that goes back to the spirits. Because before we came into the flesh, we were spirits, angels, if you will. And the scriptures tell us that there are the righteous angels and there are the wicked angels, the evil angels, okay? And the Heavenly Father controls them both. Let's read that real quick. Evil angels. And guess what? The evil angels, which we call demons, which the word demon, like I said, means intelligence, but the evil angels, they know who we are. Okay, they know the true servants of Yahweh Barshem Yahweh Shai, and they're going to persecute them. And the evil angels, they come through people. And this video here of this woman here, if you can call her that, is a perfect example of that. Okay, I mean, one look at this woman, you can tell. There's a saying, the eyes are the windows of the soul, right? The eyes are the windows of the spirit. You can see that this woman is possessed with demons, and the demons know who you are. That's why you can't, in this thing of ours, in this ministry, you can't fake it, man. Because eventually, if you're faking it, eventually we read about the vagabond Jews who were faking it. And eventually the spirits caught up with that guy and beat the hell out of him. Okay, we read about that. And then in the book of Acts, and then when you read the account, it said that brought fear among the people, that incident. Okay, so this is proof that the evil spirits know exactly who we are. That's why you can't fake it in this thing of ours. That's how serious this thing of ours is. And the evil spirits that was in this woman mentioned the men of the Lord by name. First, it started with Elder Pastor. And throughout the years, I've seen many evil spirits call out Elder Pastor. You know, so they know him. All right. Then my name was mentioned a couple of times. Apostle Elder Ramlov, his name was mentioned. Apostle Elder Rakar. So what does that tell you people out there? That we are known, man. That the evil spirits, the evil demons know who we are. And we're going to read some of those accounts in the scriptures. Okay? So you got to look past this woman here, right? The so-called black woman. You got to look at this thing spiritually. Okay? Now, when I first saw it, I was laughing. I was laughing, but then I regrouped and said, well, I got to look at this thing spiritually. Okay. I got to look at this thing spiritually because, you know, we've seen this before many times. Okay. So to us, beginning with Elder Pastor on down, to us, this is just another day at the office. We've seen this so many times, being in the faith, being in the truth. But if you listen to what the demons were saying through this woman, it proves one thing, that the demons, the evil spirits, they know exactly who the men of the Lord are, okay? And like Elder Pastor did
What's the
Elder problem? Elder Pastor did a...
It leaks? Huh?
Hold on, let me pause this thing here. Elder Pastor did a video on that very subject. This is the video right here. The demons know who we are and they tell the truth. Okay, and he was going through the book of Mark, I believe it's the 5th chapter, and we're going to go through that in this lesson too. And I want to play his video because he made a couple of heavy points, okay? So let me see, where should I start? All right. Okay, yeah, this is a scripture I wanted to bring out. Because I mentioned about you got the righteous angels and you got the evil angels, right? Here's a scripture which proves this. This is the book of Psalm 78. Psalm 78 and 49. He cast upon them the fierceness of his anger. Who's this talking about? The Heavenly Father, Yahweh. And his only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai. All right? He cast upon them the fierceness of his anger, wrath and indignation and trouble by sending evil angels among them. Okay, evil angels, and we call them demons, right? And they know exactly who we are. They know who we are, those of us that are in this ministry. They know who the true worshipers are in this ministry, the elect, if you will. Okay, so this is proof that you cannot fake this. You cannot fake being in this ministry. All right. Let's go from there to what Yahweh Shai told his disciples. Right. I think it's somewhere in Luke. It is right here. This is it. Luke, the 10th chapter, beginning at the 17th verse. Luke 10 and 17. And the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, this is when Yahweh Shai gave commission to the 70 to go out there and teach the word. I think he sent them out two by two, right? And the 70 return again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject. What does it mean, the devils? Huh? Wait a minute. Even the devils So were they teaching actual devils? No. They were teaching people that had devils on them, that had spirits on them, just like that woman. And see, if that person they were teaching is a member of the elect, the devils are going to be pulled off of them, and they're going to be in their right mind. You know, just like Apostle Todd said in his video, you know, a lot of guys who can't get this truth, the reason why you can't get this truth is because you got devils on you. You got spirits riding you. You got spirits in your mind. Your mind is unclean. Okay? Your mind is not clean. Your mind is unclean. That's what the word insane means. Insane, again, etymology. When you go into the word insane, it means not clean, not sanitary. Why is the mind not sanitary? Because it has evil spirits on it. Evil spirits plaguing it. So that person is not in his right mind. Hey, there are times we're in this knowledge, we're in this truth. All of us brothers can attest to this. And you feel like when you have those unclean spirits on you, you feel like it. Like you have these unclean spirits on you. You know what you do? You pray. Praying gets rid of these unclean spirits. That's why we keep telling you brothers to pray, pray, pray. Even Yahweh Shai prayed, you know. And the word pray means to beg. And we're begging Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai to take those negative spirits off of us. And then another weapon we can do is to fast. Fasting helps to purify the mind, because fasting brings in what? Suffering, because you're denying your body, the flesh, which fights against the spirit. Remember, the Apostle Paul said that you're denying your flesh now, so you're suffering, and in turn, that what purifies the mind. This is why the scriptures say it is better for the heart, the mind, to be in the house of what? Mourning and suffering, than to be in the house of feasting. See? That's why the scripture says that. Okay, so let's read again the scripture. And the 70 return again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject unto us through thy name. So now you know what that means, the devils, meaning the spirits. That's what we're dealing with. We're dealing with spirits. Okay? And I always say, you brothers have heard me say this, I always say, what you can't see is greater than what you can see. Okay? You can't see the spirits unless Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai open up your eyes to see them. All right? You can't physically see the spirits, but it doesn't mean they're not there just because you can't see them. Like, case in point, you know, Yahweh Shai told Nicodemus about, when he was explaining to Nicodemus about the spirit, how we teach according to the Holy Spirit, he used the analogy of the wind. He said, Yahweh Shai said, the wind, no one knows where it's coming from and no one knows where it's going. And then Yahweh Shai said, so is everyone born of the spirit. So he compared the spirit, the Holy Spirit, to the wind. Okay, now you will remember, right, when the apostles, the disciples which became apostles, minus Judas Iscariot, of course, when the Holy Spirit finally did come upon them, the power, it came like a rushing mighty wind. So that's another analogy, okay? So there you go. So remember, brothers, never forget this. What you don't see is greater than what you do see, okay? And the scriptures clearly tell us we're wrestling against what? And I'm going to go into that scripture. We're wrestling against spirits, man, okay? And these spirits, they possess people and, you know, and make them do, crazy things, okay? The negative spirits, all right? So there's a lot to factor into this truth, man. Anyway, Luke 10 and 18, and he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fallen from heaven, right? Because Satan is the head of all these evil spirits, and he's the head because the Heavenly Father Yahweh set him up to be the head. He's the chief evil spirit, Satan, okay? And then you have all the demons under him, all right? All the other evil spirits under him, okay? Reading on, it says, behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions. And that's pretty much our people. The majority of them are nothing but serpents and scorpions, okay? The Lord said that his people have become wicked, all right? Anyway, Behold, I give unto you power. What's that power? The knowledge of this gospel, the knowledge of this truth, which is power indeed. Hebrews 4:12, go read that. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. And that's what's going to destroy Esau, which Esau is our main enemy. Read Psalms, the 83rd chapter, right? That's what's going to destroy him, this truth, this knowledge. Not no gun, not no tank, not no bomb, no. This truth, as it is written, the weapons of our warfare are mighty through the Heavenly Father. What's the weapons of our warfare? This knowledge, this truth. That's what's going to bring Esau to his knees, beginning with the top banking families. That's what they fear the most. This knowledge, this truth in the hands of a Hebrew Israelite, one that has woken up from the truth. That's what the wicked elite, they fear the most, okay? One who has woken up from this truth. And that's where we come in, Elder Pastor on down. Our job is to, we have learned this truth and to go out and teach the Lord's people, you know? And the only ones that's going to be gathered by this truth is the elect. The elect, okay? Anyway, behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. So yeah, so we don't need, like, you got this group, right? Sicarii, they bringing out guns and just in case they run into an altercation while they out there teaching the truth. Well, that shows you they don't have no faith. That shows you that they don't understand the scriptures, because clearly Yahweh Shai told the 70 that he sent out to teach, he said, nothing shall by any means hurt you. Another thing too, when we're out there teaching, the angels are around us, right? Again, it is written, the angels encampeth. Let me show you that. Okay, Psalms. So for these guys to bring out guns to the camp, that means you have no faith. You err not knowing the scriptures, number one. Number two, you do not trust in the power of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. It is right here, Psalm 34:7. Basically, you have no faith. And that reminds me of the scripture, children in whom there is no faith. Okay? Psalm 34:7, it says, the angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him and delivereth them. So when we out there doing the work, we out there on the street, the angels of the Lord are around us. Okay, just like it says here, the angel, the scriptures don't lie, brothers. Psalm 34:7, the angel of the Lord encampeth. Just because you can't see the angel of the Lord don't mean the angel ain't there. And sometimes the angel, they come in human form. Okay, what's it tell us in Hebrews? Let me finish read that scripture and we'll go to that one. This scripture and we'll go to the next one. Psalm 34:7, the angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him and delivereth them. Now, let's go to Hebrews. I think it's somewhere in Hebrews. Hebrews 13, I think it is. Yeah, this is it. Hebrews 13, beginning at the first verse, it says, let brotherly love continue. Be not forgetful to entertain strangers, for thereby some have entertained angels unawares. So sometimes the angels, they could come in human form, okay? They could come in human form. And throughout the years, we've seen this being out there in the camp. Okay, we've seen, especially when we used to be out there on 34th and 7th. All right, one guy in particular that comes to mind, that guy had to be, he had to have been an angel. You brothers know who I'm talking about, the gentleman who had that, he had that chiseled look. You know, he was an older guy, he had that gray hair. And I remember one particular Saturday, we were out there teaching, and it was freezing, man. We had coats on and we were freezing. And this guy was walking around, I think he had short, he had a t-shirt on or something like that. And he was a Jake. And then Elder Pastor felt sorry for him. He said, hey, brother, you want us to go? Because lower down the street, there was this store called Conway. And they sell, you know, socks and, you know, stuff like that and underwear and, you know, t-shirts and coats and all that. It was a clothing store, right? And Elder Pastor asked him, hey, brother, you want us to get you a coat? He said, no, I don't need that. And he was walking back and forth, you know, just walk like he was patrolling the camp, you know, but not in a negative way, in a positive way. His presence was noted, man. I'm telling you, that guy was an angel, okay? He was sent to our camp. And throughout the years, angels have come to the camp. I remember on 44th and Broadway, every now and then, you know, a guy come up and something about him. He could have been an angel, you know? So the scriptures say, the point is, the scriptures say, be not forgetful to entertain strangers, for thereby some have entertained angels unawares. And like I say, the scriptures do not lie, okay? So getting back to Luke 10, all right? Luke 10 and 19, behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. So brothers, you got to know that when you're out there teaching, you're not alone. There are forces beyond this world that are around you, protecting you, okay? Notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, all right? But rather rejoice, here it is, this proves that the demons know who we are. The demons know who we are. And when I say demons, I'm talking about the negative forces, the negative spirits. They know exactly who we are. That's why every now and then they will call you by name, because they know who you are. Remember, man, we've been chosen to do this work even before. The scriptures tell us that in Ephesians, and I'm going to go to that one. Ephesians, right? We were chosen even before the earth was created. Now wrap your head around that. And that right there proves reincarnation, because you got this crackpot, this wacky-tacky Christian, Vocab Malone, who doesn't believe in reincarnation. Yeah, because the understanding of the scriptures was not given to him, okay? Number one, we believe he's not even an Israelite. He's a heathen. And clearly in Psalm 147, it clearly says, he showeth his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He have not dealt so with any nation. And as for his statutes and his judgments, this knowledge, this truth, this Bible, they have not known them, praise ye the Lord. Clearly that's written in Psalm 147. So the Lord ain't dealing with any other nation but the nation of Israel, and not just any Israelite. He's dealing with the elect right now. And the names of the elect are written in heaven, which is what I'm about to read, and the demons know them and call them by name. And we see that example, that the latest example is that woman, okay? This woman right here, that's the latest example, okay? So you have to look at this thing spiritually, man. Luke 10 and 20, notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your name, this is Yahushua saying this. Why would Yahushua lie? Would he lie? No, he wouldn't lie. Okay, he told the truth. Luke 10 and 20, notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. See? There it is. Your names are written in heaven. So what does this tell? What does that tell us? The spirits know exactly who we are. Okay? They know who we are. All right? Let's go from there to Ephesians. Because I mentioned that scripture. Ephesians, I think it's the first chapter. Yep. Ephesians, the first chapter. Now, this was a letter that the Apostle Paul wrote to the Israelites in Ephesus. And recently I was going through the history. Ephesus was a major church at that time, a major congregation, a huge congregation was at Ephesus. And the Apostle Paul was over that church, that congregation. And one of the men that worked with the Apostle Paul was Timothy, I believe. Now, according to the account that I read, Timothy was a bishop of that church. In Ephesus was a huge congregation of Israelites that returned to the truth. All right. So let's read what's said here by the Apostle Paul, right, to the Israelites in Ephesus. I believe Ephesus is known as Turkey today. That region called Turkey today was once called Ephesus. Now, if I'm wrong, your brothers can correct me in the comment section. If I'm right, you can back me up, okay? All you have to do is a little research, right? Ephesians 1 and 1. Paul, an apostle of Yahushua. Now, check this out. Paul, an apostle of Yahushua. Apostle just means sent away. You know, those that get butthurt by the word. That's the same guy who doesn't do research, who doesn't look up words, who doesn't know about etymology. The word apostle just means sent away. So anyone that learns this truth and is sent away to teach it, they're an apostle. Now you have the chief apostles. The chief apostles start with who? The 12 apostles minus Judas Iscariot, who was replaced by, I believe the brother's name was Matthias. Okay? And you can find that account in the book of Acts, which completed the 12 after Judas betrayed Yahushua. And it was set up for Judas to do that. Judas was set up by the Heavenly Father Yahweh to do what he did. He had to fulfill prophecy. He was that guy. He was chosen, okay, to fulfill what he did, which is betray Yahushua. So that right there kills free will. You got people that talk about free will. Oh, we got free will. No, there's no such thing as free will. Everything has been predestinated. And we're going to read that. It's funny I said that because we're going to read that in the book of Ephesians, the first chapter. Everything is predestinated, man. Okay? Anyway, Paul, an apostle of Yahushua. Now here it comes. Here's the point. By the will of Yahweh. By the will of Yahweh. Right? And just like Yahushua always said when he prayed to the Father, he always said, let thy will be done. So if it's the will of the Heavenly Father for you to know this truth, learn this truth, you're going to know it. You're going to learn it. If it's not the will of the Heavenly Father for you to not know the truth, you're not going to know it. There's nothing you can do. If it's the will of the Heavenly Father for you to be, or for we to be, a member of the elect, guess what? We're going to be a member of the elect, and we're not going to be deceived. Like the scriptures say, if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. It's not possible to deceive the elect. Why? Because they're the elect. They've been chosen. And as we're going to read in this passage here, they were chosen even before the earth was created. Okay? And that proves reincarnation. Because every time they were reincarnated, they were in the truth. They knew a little of the truth. Until now the reincarnation now, us brothers coming back now we're coming back to finish our course. Now we're coming back to know all the truth. Okay? But that's another video for another time. Paul, an apostle of Yahushua, by the will of Yahweh, to the saints which are at Ephesus. Who are the saints? Israelites. And these were the ones who woke up to the truth. To the saints who are at Ephesus, and I gave you some history about Ephesus. It was a major church there. And to the faithful in Yahushua. Right, those that knew the truth. Grace be to you. And guess what? We're of that group. Okay? Now, we're reading this, right? To the saints, which are at Ephesus, and to the faithful in Yahushua. Guess what? The same spirits that were back there, that the Apostle Paul is speaking to in this letter, those same spirits are back now. And we're those guys. We're those individuals. We're back in this generation. And that goes back to what I said earlier about the reincarnation. Even before the earth was created, every time we were reincarnated, right, which the word reincarnated means back into the flesh, when we die, the scriptures tell us we go to the Heavenly Father, right, when we die, right? We go to, as a matter of fact, let's get that in Ecclesiastes 12. Forgive me, I hope I'm not all over the place, all right, but there's certain points come up. And there's certain points that got to be made with scriptures. The scriptures say prove all things, right? So here it is. Ecclesiastes 12 and 7. Then shall the dust return. That's what we're in, the dust, these bodies, right? Then shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto... Remember, this video is dealing with spirits, right? With subject matter is spirits, right? And the spirit shall return unto the Father who gave it. So the spirit never dies. And the spirit itself has a body. And that goes before Yahweh Bashim Yahushua in the heavens, in the spirit world. And we go we go back before Yahweh Bashim Yahshua to be judged for what we did in the body while we're in the body. So we've been reincarnated many times. That's the point. 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, that's why history repeats itself, because the same spirit keeps coming back over and over again. Generation, the word generation, again, when you go back to etymology, the word generation means just that, generated. Anything that's generated keeps coming back over and over and over again. It's a cycle, okay? You've heard the saying, the circle of life, okay? 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter. Now, we just read in Ecclesiastes, right? Of when what happens when we die. We go before the throne of Yahweh Bashim Yahshai to be judged for what we did in the body while we were on the earth. Here it is right here. 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Yahweh, and this happens at death, okay? That everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that he have done, whether it be good or bad. And then you're sent back to the earth. You're reincarnated back on the earth. You receive a new body. As a matter of fact, in the etymology dictionary, when you look up the word reincarnation, literally you'll see that a new embodiment. Okay, this is why it is written in Exodus 20. Here's another clue. Exodus 20, and let's start the 3rd verse. It says, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt have no other gods before me, right? This is the Heavenly Father Yahweh speaking. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Now here's the point. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them, for I, the Lord thy power, am a jealous power, visiting the iniquity of the fathers, because we're regenerated through our fathers. Why? Because the father carries the seed. And even people that don't know the truth know that, that the father carries the seed. You are who your father is. The father carries the seed in his nutsack, okay? The father brings back the family. That's why the father is the head of the family. No matter how feminism is trying to destroy that concept, they can't, all right? The father, the patriarchy, is the head of the family, not the matriarchy, okay? So it says, for I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers, and we're generated through our fathers, upon the children of the 3rd and 4th generation of them that hate me. Why is it the 3rd and 4th generation? Because that's around the time you come back through your family line. We are reincarnated through our family line, our fathers. And it includes the man as well as the woman, okay? That's how the Heavenly Father set it up. All right. This is why we tell Esau, look, you're going to have to pay for the crimes you committed in the past. And they say, well, I didn't commit it. It was my father, forefather. Well, you are your forefathers. That's what you don't know. You are your forefathers coming back, reincarnated. Okay. The scriptures clearly teach this. Okay. That's the understanding of reincarnation according to the Bible. All right. So, you know, Elder Pastor always says lessons within lessons, all right? So I hope I didn't stray too far from the point of this video. But the point of this video is the spirits know who we are, okay? The demons know who we are, all right? Ephesians, the 1st chapter, going back to Ephesians, the 1st chapter, 2nd verse. So again, well, let's read the 1st verse again. Paul, an apostle of Yahweh, by the will of Yahweh, not by our will, by the will of Yahweh. Okay, so if it's the will of Yahweh for us to be a member of the elect, we're going to be a member of the elect. Okay, to the saints which are at Ephesus and to the faithful in Yahweh, grace be to you and peace from our power, our Father, and from the Lord Yahweh. Blessed be the power and Father of our Lord Yahweh, who have blessed us with all spiritual blessings. What's an example of that? Giving us this knowledge, this truth. This is a spiritual blessing. All right? And the spiritual, brothers, never forget this. The spiritual is greater than the physical. Like people in the world, right? People of this world that are blessed, they have the physical blessings. They have the carnal blessings, right? Which doesn't last. Okay? What does the scripture say? The fashion of this world shall pass away. So these top, you know, among our people, these top movie actors and these top celebrities, these top athletes and all that, they got the carnal blessings. Now, we that have this knowledge that endures forever, right? We that have this truth, we have the spiritual blessings. And I'm telling you, I'd rather get the spiritual blessings than the carnal blessings. Because the spiritual is greater. The spiritual is also always greater than the physical, man. The spiritual is always greater than the physical, all right? Much greater, okay? What you don't see is greater than what you do see, okay? All right? Blessed be the power, our Father, of our Lord Yahushua, who have blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Yahushua, right? Now, here's the point, which is why I went to the scripture. According as he have chosen us in him. Now, we hope we've been called right now. We hope we've been chosen. As it is written, many are called, few are chosen. Okay, and that's heavy because, you know, as I end this video, we're going to read, because I'm going to play a part where Apostle Tar goes into Mark, the 5th chapter, where this guy who had demons in him, right, just like that woman, she had demons in her, right, demons speaking through her. This guy had demons in him, and there were a legion of demons, many demons, right? And Yahushua cast the demons out of him. And do you know the guy wanted to follow Yahushua? And Yahushua told him no. Why did Yahushua tell him no? Because he wasn't part of the elect. You remember what the Apostle Paul said in this letter? He said he's an apostle of Yahushua by the will of Yahweh. All right? By the will of Yahweh, man. Check that out, man. So you can't be in this knowledge and this truth unless it's the will of the Heavenly Father. You can't stay in it all the way to the end unless it's the will of the Heavenly Father. Brothers, there's no such thing as free will. We don't have control over our will. Our will comes from Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, bros. Our will comes from Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. Never forget that, man. Okay? So this is why it makes the most sense to keep praying and begging. You can't pray enough, man. Okay, you can't pray enough in this thing of ours. You can't pray enough. And the main thing we keep praying for is, oh, Yahweh Bashim Yahushua, please have mercy upon us. You know, please have mercy upon us. In other words, let us make it into the kingdom, man. Let us be, when Yahushua comes back with that great wrath, let us be delivered by your great son, Yahushua. Let us be one of his elect. Please, oh, Yahweh Bashim Yahushua, please have mercy upon us. That's the smartest thing we can do, man. That's the smartest thing, honestly, that is, this, especially now, in these times, that's the smartest thing we can do, brothers. And I'm speaking to you, brothers, that care and believe in this truth. I'm not speaking to you reprobates. I'm not speaking to you scorners. I'm not speaking to you scoffers. You got your job to do. Just like Judas. You're just like Judas. He had his job to do. All right? Now, I'm talking to the true worshipers that believe in spirit and in truth. This knowledge, this understanding. That's who I'm talking to, okay? Anyway, Ephesians, the 1st chapter, the 3rd verse. Blessed be the power, the Most High, and the Father of our Lord Yahushua, who have blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Yahushua. And that's exactly what we got. Remember what Yahushua told the 70? He said, your names are written in heaven. Right? So that's a comfort to us, man. We are known in high places, man. That's why even the demons come out and call our names. Just like you saw with this woman. Okay? Now here's the point. According as he have chosen us in him before the foundation of the world. So that proves reincarnation. Before the world was created, it was foreordained. And that proves so many things, man. That proves reincarnation, number one. That proves there's no such thing as free will, number two, which we learned from Esau. You have free will, control over you. That's all nonsense. Man's goings are of the Lord. How can a man then understand his own way? Clearly, that's written. All right? What is that? Jeremiah. Let's go to that real quick. Jeremiah 10 and 23. These are the bread and butter scriptures that I learned when I first came into the truth. And throughout the years, they've stuck in my mind, man. One of them is Jeremiah 10:23. Let's read it. It says, "O Lord, I know that the way of man is not in himself." Oh, Lord. So those of us that know the truth, we know the deal. We know there's no such thing as free will. All right. That's part of knowing the truth. Right. Oh, Lord, I know that the way of man is not in himself. It is not in man that walketh to direct his steps. So who directs his steps? The steps of man, whether he does good or evil. Who directs him? The Heavenly Father, man. That's why it makes so much sense to fear the Heavenly Father. You getting it now? Okay, he's in control. Yahweh Shai gave a clue. He said, a sparrow don't fall to the ground unless the Heavenly Father sanctioned it. That's what Yahweh Shai said. So anything that happens, it was meant to happen. Okay, it was meant to happen by the will. Remember what the Apostle Paul said? By the will of the Heavenly Father, I am an apostle. Well, guess what? Anything that was meant to happen, it happened because it was by the will of Yahweh Bashim Yahshai. Nothing can happen unless it's the will of Yahweh Bashim Yahshai. It doesn't matter if it's good or evil. Okay? Here's another one for you. Proverbs 16:9. It says, a man's heart deviseth his way, but the Lord directeth his steps. And Esau don't teach that, because why? Esau, the scriptures tell us about Esau. The Most High is not in all their thoughts. Okay? They're not set up to teach the truth. They're the wicked. All right? Esau is the wicked. Esau is the devil. Beginning with their top banking families. So don't look to get the truth from Esau, okay? It's as simple as that. And Esau is getting ready to lose his power. Okay, that's what we're in the time of the great transition from the wicked to the righteous, okay? Esau is the wicked. He's being phased out. The righteous are coming in, beginning with Yahweh Shai and the rest of us Israelites. It's our time to rule now. Esau already had his time. He's passé, okay? Ephesians 1:4, according as he have chosen us. But Esau ain't gonna go out without a fight. You better believe it. He's gonna fight to the very last. You know, he's gonna lose, but it doesn't mean he's not gonna fight. Okay, he's gonna fight to the very last tooth and nail. Anyway, fingernail, that is. Ephesians 1:4, according as he have chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love. That's the elect. So no matter what, the elect are never going to be deceived. They're not going to go off, because they're chosen to be the elect. And I hope I'm a member of that group, as we all do. Those of us that are listening to this truth and believing it, as we all do, we hope we're members of the elect. Because when Yahweh Shai comes, who is he going to gather? Matthew 24:30. He's going to gather his elect, okay? That are scattered over the four corners of the earth. Now, at this point, let me play some of El Apostar's video, and then I'm going to wrap this video up.
It says that he asked him, what is thy name? And he answered, saying, my name is Legion, for we are many. And he besought him much that he would not send them away out of the country.
So that was the demon that gave Yahweh Shai asked the demon. That guy was possessed by all those demons. Yahweh Shai asked him, well, what is your name? And the demon, it was the demons in the guy, replied to Yahweh Shai, because Yahweh Shai had power over the demons. The demons replied to Yahweh Shai, we are legion. My name is Legion, for we are many. All right, just like that woman you saw in the video, you know, spouting her madness. All right, those were the spirits speaking through her. Okay? This woman here.
What's the problem to her? Huh?
Now you notice.
I'm smacking your.
Hold up. Hold up, man. I wish I would have got that one picture. You could see the demon piercing through her eyes. Now the demon mentioned Taha. All right. So the demons know who we are. Okay. And it's a fact, whether you accept it or not. Elder Apostar is a major force within this ministry. So you're going to tell me the demons don't know who he is? And throughout the years, I've seen many demons come against Elder Apostle Tar. And then filtered down the line, came against me, came against Elder Apostle Ricard, and then came against Elder Apostle Ramla. Because they know who we are, man. And not just us, the rest of the brothers, you know, the elders in Connecticut. Over the years, demons have come against them. Now, we used to have that school in Bridgeport. Every time we showed our shows on cable, the very next day, we'd get all kind of calls to the school, you know, bomb threats. We're going to blow up your school, nigga. You know, all kind of. We even made a collage. I wish I had that with me right now to play to you, brothers. We even made a collage of the different calls we were getting. We were getting from people, and how they're going to do this to us and they're going to do that to us. So we've seen, you know, this woman, we've seen that so many times over the years, man. But that's those negative spirits who know who we are. That's the point. They know who we are. That's why you can't fake being in this ministry, man.
Now, there was there nigh unto the mountains a great herd of swine feeding. It was 2,000, or about 2,000, it's going to say. And all the devils, with an S, 7,000 devils, besought him. They all, at the same time, you heard 7,000 voices speaking. And all the devils besought him, the Lord, saying, send us into the swine.
That another thing, too, about the devils, not only do they know who we are, they know that we have power over them. Okay? So in some certain way, they'll show you respect. But like I mentioned about the vagabond Jews, all right, when you read that account, well, what did the demon say? Let's get that about the vagabond Jews, which the word vagabond just means traveler. It's not a bad word. People, you're a vagabond. You know, they say it to you as if they're insulting you. People don't know the meaning of words, man. That's a fact. Okay. It is right here. Let's read it real quick. Acts 19. Then certain, now these are the guys that fake it. This is what happens to you when you fake being in this ministry. Eventually the spirits are going to get you, man. That's why the scriptures speak about counting the cost, whether you're able to finish this ministry. And in all honesty, it's better that you never learn this truth and then to fall out of it. You know, you never learned it. You know, you never came into it. Because if you come into this thing and you fall out, oh, man. You know, me personally, I'd rather death. All right, just Yahabashi Me'ashai, just put me to death, man. Because my sole purpose, I've been doing this for more than half my life. So it's obvious I was chosen to do this, what I'm doing, this ministry. That's my purpose. Anyway, Acts 19 and 13. Then certain of the vagabond Jews, exorcists, took upon them to call over them which had evil spirits. See? What I say in this video, we're dealing with what? With the subject matter is evil spirits, right? That come through people who and know who we are, right? Call over them which had evil spirits, the name of the Lord Yahushai. It's very important. That's why it's so powerful to know the name of the Father and the Son. Saying, we adjure you by Yahushai whom Paul preacheth. And there were seven sons of one Savior, a Jew, and chief of the priests which did so. So this guy, Savior, he had seven sons. His occupation was he was a chief priest, right? A high priest, if you will. And the evil spirit answered and said, Yahushai I know, and Paul I know. Now remember what Yahushai told the 70? Rejoice that your names are written in heaven. So the evil spirits know who we are, man. There's proof right there. So that woman that you saw in the video spouting her madness, the evil spirits within her know who we are. And that's why they called us out by name, starting with Elder Apostle Tar. Tar, what's the problem? What's the problem? That wasn't that woman's talking. That was the evil spirits within her talking. Okay, this thing is deep, man. And the evil spirit answered and said, Yahweh Shai, I know. And Paul, I know. But who are you? Who are ye? I don't know you. You ain't on the list. All right, the evil spirits, man. And the woman in whom the evil spirit was, did I say woman? Salakia. If I said woman, Salakia, I'm thinking about that. And the man in whom the evil spirit and the man in whom the evil spirit was leaped on them and overcame them and prevailed against them, so that they fled out of that house naked and wounded. There you go. And then as we read on, it says, and this was known to all the Jews and Greeks. Those were Israelites. Greeks there. Israelites that spoke Greek. Also dwelling at Ephesus, a major congregation, a major church. And fear fell on them all, and the name of the Lord Yahweh Shai was magnified. See? So that's why that happened. So that Yahweh Shemiah Shai could magnify, you know, the names. Okay, so more things are getting ready to happen at this time to magnify the name of Yahweh Hashem Yahshai. Absolutely. But what's the point? The point is the evil spirit said, look, I know Yahweh Shai and I know Paul, but who the hell are you? All right, so again, you can't fake being in this ministry because the spirits know who you are. They know. They know if you're on the list to be the Lord's elect, the chosen, and they know if you're not. How about that? That's why Elder Pastor's title was, the demons know who we are and they tell the truth. Let's listen some more.
Why? That we may enter into them. And see, when a demon is exercised from somebody, you know what it does? You exercise a demon, it goes, is looking for a new host. Mm-hmm. A new body. And then it sees a body and it said, boom, let me go into that individual right there.
Yep.
They showed you that in the movie Fallen with Denzel Washington. It says 13 verse. And forthwith Yahweh Shai gave them leave. In other words, he like a military, you get leave, you know, you get R&R. Rest and relaxation. You get liberty. If you're on a sailing ship, the sailors get liberty, meaning you can go out, but you got to be back here at a certain time. So that shows you that there's an order in heaven, and that the demons and the righteous angels and the demons are all in the spiritual realm, including the spiritual demon Satan.
Yep, and they know who we are. That's why you can't fake being in this thing, man. The spirits know who we are. They know who's part of the truth and they know who's not. All right? And every now and then they will mention you by name.
He's not down in hell. He's up in the heavens. He's up in the spiritual realm.
Yeah, and a lot of people don't understand about the spirit world. The spirit world is greater than the physical world, all right? Much greater. Okay, and that's another video for another time. There's the spirit world and there's this physical world. We're in the physical world right now, but there's a world greater than this world. It's called the spirit world, a whole nother world, man. Okay,
and for you wacky tacky Christians out there, there was no war in heaven where the Satan got all the other demons and had them to fight, and there was no war in heaven. Okay, the demons are still in the spiritual realm in heaven, so you can understand. 13 verse, and forthwith Yahweh Shai gave them leave. He allowed, okay, yeah, you can go into them pigs, to them the swine, and the unclean spirits went out and entered into the swine, and the herd ran violently down a steep place into the sea, Why did the herd do that? Because they sense, you know, the scripture say an ox in Isaiah, an ox know of his own and an ass his master's crib, but Israel does not know, my people does not consider. You got Jakes out there that welcome demons, man. They're called.
That's true. And we, those of us that are locked in into this knowledge, this truth, we can sense, we can sense when we have evil spirits on us. And what we do is we'll pray or we'll fast to get rid of those evil spirits. If peradventure Yahweh Shemal Shai acknowledges that, then we can sense when people have evil spirits on them. Just like that woman. That woman got evil spirits on her, plaguing her, okay? That's why she said the shit that she said. Those were the demons talking through her, okay? And if you understand this knowledge, this truth, you'll understand about that. You'll understand about the spirit world, the rules concerning the spirit world.
Born demons. Any of you that can't see that you're an Israelite, you can't see that this is the truth, guess what? There's a spirit on you blocking you from seeing this truth, or from your eyes being wide open. And that's from the order of the Most High. Yep. Go back and read Isaiah chapter 6 again.
And Isaiah 6 is beautiful because it goes right into it. How the Heavenly Father has sent an evil angel to blind you from not seeing the truth. Clearly that's written in Isaiah the 6th chapter. And Elder Pastor, I know that for a fact. He's been bringing out that scripture for years. He always goes to that scripture. Okay? All right, so at this point, I'll let it go there. Hopefully you were edified. And so on to the next one.